fellow students, today we cover the second chapter of the novel The Three Men in a Boat, written by Jerome K. Jerome. The decision having made about a trip up the river, the friends started planning their trip. They will start from Kingston on Saturday and George will join them at Chertsey in the afternoon, when his bank closes. The next decision is where to sleep at night, at inns or camp out. George and the writer opted for camping out. In fact, the writer becomes almost lyrical about the sun fading at night, birds becoming silent, only the sounds of moorhen a corncake, the hush around them. Night's ghostly army steps out, darkening the world, lit only by pale stars. In a nostalgic mood, he describes how they run to tie the boat into some quiet nook, pitch their tent and eat a frugal meal. They listen to the song of river. Watch the moon stoop down to kiss its sister, the river, and then overcome by sleep, they lie down under the stars and dream that the world is young again, before overtaken by care and anxiety. He painted civilization as luring man away from nature's loving arms. The writer's poetic mood is punctured by the practical, unpoetic Harris. How about when it rained? Harris weeps only when he has been eating raw onions. Harris, in any situation, even in paradise, will talk about a nice place round the corner, where you could get drink. But for once he was right. It's unpleasant to camp out in rainy weather. It is hopeless attempting to make a wood fire. So they light a stove. Their diet at supper has rainwater as the chief article. The bread is 2/3 rainwater, the pie, the jam, butter and salt, coffee have all become rich with rainwater. You are rudely awakened from your sleep, because you feel an elephant sitting on your chest and that a volcano had erupted around you. When you feel the end of the world has come, you hear faint cries coming from under your bed. This somebody fights with you. He looks like a half-dressed ruffian ready to kill you, and then you recognize each other as George and Jim. The writer, you realize that the blessed tent has fallen down, and at the same time you look for Harris. He shouts at George and the writer to get off my bed, and thinks that they both had done it deliberately. In the morning, all three are speechless due to severe cold caught in the night, feel quarrelsome and swear at each other in hoarse whispers. The decision is made, they would sleep out on fine nights in a hotel or pub when it rains. Even Montmorency hails this. Montmorency looks like an angel in the shape of fox terrier, with such a noble look in his eyes. The writer, when he first owned him, thought he would not live long. But after rescuing him from hundreds of street fights, paying for a dozen chickens killed by him, or neighbor angrily accusing him of killing her cat, the writer changes his mind. The only thing now to do is to decide what to take. When Harris puts an end to a new argument, by suggesting that he knows a place round the corner where they would get excellent Irish whiskey, George, of course, is very thirsty, and with common consent the three put on their hats and go out. Thank you. Please make sure to like the video and subscribe to our channel. In the next video, we shall study chapter 3. We hope you understood the summary of the lesson. We wish you the very best. Until next time, bye.